Hello and welcome. My name is Seth O'Farrell. I'm FDI's Global Investment Reporter, and I'm here at UKREiiF in Leeds in the north of England. And I'm delighted to be joined by Deborah Cadman, Chief Executive of Birmingham City Council. Deborah, Birmingham just launched a very ambitious project to become greener and more interconnected than ever by 2040. What does this plan consist of, and how are you going to achieve it?
This plan is the most ambitious plan that Birmingham has seen in a generation. And we're responding to some of the global challenges around how cities grow and flourish and thrive. We're very mindful of the need to change the way the city moves and the way in which we enable people to live and work and thrive. We're very mindful of that. So the plan is ambitious, and we make no apologies for that. The people of the city deserve no less, but equally we need to create an environment where global investment want to come and invest in our city.
And what sorts of foreign investors are you looking at then?
We're not precious, but it has to be the right investment. And what I mean by that is we're very clear that if people want to invest significantly in the city, they have to do it on our terms, actually, which is you can't just arrive, make your profit, and then bounce. We want people who are prepared to invest in the long term. We want people who are prepared to invest in the community just as much as they are in the economy and in the infrastructure. So we want people to have a stake in the future of the city and be part of that.
And you mentioned the community. Still, Birmingham is a city of deprivation in certain quarters, with over 40% of children in relative poverty. How do you ensure that everybody comes along with you in this journey?
Well, inclusive growth has got to be at the heart of everything that we do. So, you know, for every pound we invest in the city, you know, we've got to be able to demonstrate that people will benefit from that. So, and that may be through skills provision, it might be through social value with the contracts that we let to ensure that local businesses benefit from that. It could be that some of the investors invest directly in our schools and the culture offer and the environment, etc. And what we're finding is that certainly global investors are really committed to the ESG agenda. So we've found investors and developers in particular really keen to be on this journey with us and want to do that.
One of the themes at UKREiiF has been the levelling up agenda, which has been criticised by certain people in certain sectors. What do you think regeneration, or what form will regeneration in cities outside of London take in the 2020s?
I'm absolutely clear that levelling up is more than just infrastructure in the hard stuff like roads and rail. It's got to be more than that. It's got to be about investing in the way in which people live, in the way in which people work and are encouraged to work. The way in which people love, and you've heard me talk about that. I think it's really important that we just, you know, give just as much thought to how people nourish their souls through culture and art and green open spaces as it is to giving them the opportunity to get a degree or, you know, skills that they need.
Deborah Cadman, thank you very much.
It's been my pleasure. Thank you.